Students, today we shall discuss about the Rogowski coil integrator. Before going to the topic, a Rogowski coil named by a Valti Rogowski coil. Okay, it is an electrical device for measuring alternating current or high speed current pulses. Okay, it is an electrical device for measuring alternating current or high speed current pulses. Okay, it consists of a helical coil of wire with a lead from one end returning through the center of the coil to the other end, so that both terminals are at the same end of the coil. This Rogowski coil is a toroid of wire used to measure an alternating current through a cable encircled by the toroid. You can observe, if a Rogowski coil integrator design is placed surrounding a current carrying conductor, the voltage signal induced in the coil is Vi of t is equal to M di by dt, where M is the mutual inductance between the conductor and the coil. I of t is the current flowing in the conductor. Usually the coil is wound on a non-magnetic form of toroidal shape and is coaxially surrounding the carrying conductor. The whole assembly is then wrapped around the straight conductor whose current is to be measured. In this, the voltage induced in the coil is proportional to the rate of change of current in the straight conductor. That is what Vi of t is equal to M into Di of t divided by dt. Next, where Vi of t is an induced voltage in the coil, that is M Di of t divided by dt, Z0 is a coaxial cable of surge impedance. R and C is the integrating network. Usually an integrating network, we have discussed already, integrating circuit is employed to, that means we have used here integrating circuit. Why we are using means to get the output signal voltage proportional to the current. Okay, that's why we are using here integrating circuit. The output voltage is Vm of t is equal to 1 divided by CR integration of 0 to t Vi of t is equal to M divided by CR into I of t. Okay, this is Rogowski coil integrator design with an electronic or active integrator circuits which have a large bandwidth, that is 100 megahertz, and also frequencies are greater than 100 megahertz, and the response is affected by the skin effect. Okay, because of frequency is greater than 100 megahertz, the response will be affected by the skin effect, and the capacitance distributed per unit length along the Rogowski coil integrator design due to the electromagnetic interference. Okay, the capacitance distributed per unit length along the Rogowski coil integrator design, because why? Due to electromagnetic interference. Because of that, capacitance are distributed per unit length. Okay, miniature probes having nanosecond response time are made using very few tons of copper strips for UHF measurements. Next topic is magnetic links. Magnetic links are short, highly retentivity steel strips arranged on circular wheel or drum. These strips have the property that remnant magnetism for current pulse 0.5%, 0.5 to 5 microseconds, as same as caused by the DC current of the same value. Magnetic links are short and high retentivity steel strips. It is arranged on a circular wheel or a drum, okay, that have a magnetism for a current pulse is 0.5 to 5 microseconds, okay. That is same because same caused by the DC current of the same value. This can be used for measurement of peak value of impulse currents. This magnetic links can be used for measurement of value of impulse current. These strips will be kept at a known distance from the current carrying conductor and parallel to it. These strips, what they will do? These strips will be kept at a known distance. Okay. Known distance from the current carrying conductor and parallel to it. The remanent magnetism is then measured in the laboratory from which the peak value of the current can be estimated. First, they will measure in the laboratory, okay, magnetism, how much current, or they will measure in the laboratory. From that, they will estimate the peak value of current. These are useful for field measurements and mainly for estimating the lightning currents on the transmission lines and towers. These are useful for field measurements and also mainly for estimating the lightning currents on the transmission lines and also for towers. By using a number of links, okay, accurate measurement of the peak value, polarity and the percentage oscillation in lightning current can be made. By using number of links, we can measure the peak value, polarity also, and also percentage oscillations in lightning currents. Okay. Next is the rate of rise of impulse currents. In this, we are considering time also. The rate of rise of impulse currents can be measured. This also can be measured by using the magnetic links. By placing them, how they will place magnetic field of inductors which carry the main current to be measured. Okay, placing them within the magnetic field. Okay, magnetic links will be placed within the magnetic field of conductors which carry the main current. Okay, we need to measure that. Okay. The inductors are connected in series with the different value of resistors. Okay, the inductors are connected in series with a different value of resistance which give a different time constants. Okay, hence the magnetic link record the peak current whose value are different. Okay, and that's why magnetic links record the peak currents whose values will be different. Knowing the time constants of the resistance inductance combination, the mean rate of rise of current in the main circuit is estimated. Knowing that time constants of the resistance inductance combination, the mean rate of rise of current in the main circuit can be estimated. Okay, if we know the time constants of the resistance inductance combination, then we can find out the rate of rise of current in the main circuit. Okay, next is different techniques for measurement of high impulse current. Okay, we have discussed yesterday in last class Hall generators. Okay, Hall, we have discussed that in last class, Hall generators. This is all generators for DC measurement, right? In last class, we have discussed that. Hall generators earlier can be used for AC and impulse current measurements also. The bandwidth of such devices was formed found to be about 50 megahertz, which is suitable with compensating devices, with the suitable compensating devices and also feedback. Okay, the saturation effect in magnetic core can be minimized, and these devices are successfully used for post arc and plasma current measurements. They are saying that all generators can be used for AC and impulse current measurements also. The bandwidth of such devices are found to be about 50 megahertz, and with the suitable compensation we need to use, compensating devices we need to use, and also feedback, the saturation effect in magnetic core can be minimized. That what is the effect of the saturation effect in magnetic core can be minimized by using compensating devices or any other devices. These devices are successfully used for what? Used for post arc and plasma current measurements. Next is Faraday generator or ammeter. When a linearly polarized light beam passes through a transparent crystal, I think you have read about this in school days only. Okay, when a linearly polarized light beam passes through a transparent crystal in the presence of magnetic field, the plane or polarization of the light beam undergoes, and the angle of rotation is given by A alpha is equal to VB L. Okay, V is a constant of the crystal, which depends on the wavelength of the light, and B is the magnetic flux density, and L is the length of the crystal. To measure the waveform of a large current in extra high voltage system, an arrangement is shown like this. Okay, this is the L is a light source, and P1 is a polarizer, P2 is a analyzer, F is a crystal. Okay, F is a crystal, CRO is a recording oscilloscope, M is a filter, and C is a photo multiplier. To measure, this is a beam of light from a stabilized light source is passed through a polarizer P1 to fall on crystal F placed parallel to the magnetic field produced by the current I. You can observe a light source is falled on P1, and this will pass through the crystal, which will produce that crystal F placed parallel to the magnetic field will produce a current. Okay, magnetic field is produced by the current. The light beam undergoes rotation. Okay, of its plane of polarization after passing through the analyzer. Okay, after passing through the analyzer, P2 is an analyzer. The light beam undergoes rotation of its plane of polarization after passing through the analyzer. The beam is focused on photo multiplier. After passing through the analyzer, the beam is focused on the photo multiplier, the output of which is fed to a CRO. From this, output is fed to CRO. The output beam is filtered. Okay, you can observe here how M is a filter. Okay, output beam is filtered through M, which allows only monochromatic light. Okay, which it will filter and it will only allow the monochromatic light. The relation between the oscilloscope display and the current to be measured are complex but can be determined. The relation between the oscillograph display and the current to be measured are complex. Okay, it is complicated and also complex, but can be determined. It can be determined. This is the diagram of magneto-optical method of measuring impulse current. The advantages of this method is there is no electric connection between the source and the device. No thermal problems even for large current of several kilo amperes. And as the signal transmission is through an optical system, no insulation problems or difficulty arise for extra high voltage system. However, this device does not operate for DC current. Next topic is current transformers. Measurement of high frequency currents such as fault current in power systems, switching current, transient, and also impulse current during impulse testing of transformer can be measured using current transformer. We have already discussed about current transformers. Okay. The transformer will have a toroidal core with a central bar primary or wound primary with a single turn. The secondary side of the current with N1 primary and N2 secondary turns is given by, that is, I2 of T is equal to N1 I of T divided by N2. Usually the secondary winding is terminated by resistance R2, and CRO will be connected to a cable of surge impedance, that is Z, terminated by R equal to the surge impedance. You can observe the equation, that is I3 through the cable and terminating resistance R is given by I3 of T is equal to R2 divided by R plus R2 plus Z0 into I2 of T. And the voltage across the resistance is R is equal to V of T is equal to I3 of T into R. Okay. We know the value of I3 of T equation. You substitute and write the equation. Okay. Next, I2 of T is equal to N1 divided by N2. Okay, we know that I2 of 2 is N1 divided by N2 into I of T. Okay, I2 of T is equal to N1 divided by N2 into I of T. We know the value of I of T is that R into R2 divided by, they have substituted this one. Okay. Usually R2 is also made equal to Z0 to avoid reflections in case of impulse currents. Okay. R2 is also made equal to Z0 to avoid the reflections in case of impulse currents. The unit is usually made into epoxy resin cast unit with the primary and secondary terminals brought out on either side of the unit. The advantages of the current transformer are electrical isolation and wide measuring range with a tapped turns on secondary side, that is from 10 amps to 10 kilo amp. 10 kiloamps are more. The main limitations are bandwidth of less than 1 megahertz and distortion in the waveform. Next topic is cathode ray oscillograph for impulse measurements. Modern cathode ray oscillograph for impulse measurements are sealed tube hot cathode oscilloscope with photographic arrangement for recording the waveforms. Modern cathode ray oscillograph for impulse measurements and a sealed tube hot cathode oscilloscope with photographic arrangement for recording the waveforms. Okay, the cathode ray oscilloscope for impulse work normally used has an input voltage range from 5 millivolt per centimeter to about 20 volt per centimeter. Okay, this is input. There are probes and attenuators. Why? To handle the signals up to 600 voltage peak to peak. Okay, they have the probes, attenuators. Why? To handle the signals up to 600 voltage peak to peak. The bandwidth peak to peak means, okay, this is a peak to peak. Okay, the bandwidth and rise time of the oscilloscope should be adequate. Okay, the bandwidth and also rise time of the oscilloscope should be adequate. Rise time of 5 nanoseconds and bandwidth as high as 500 megahertz may be necessary. Sometimes high voltage surge high voltage surge test oscilloscope do not have a vertical amplifier and directly require an input voltage of 10 volt. They can take a maximum signal of about 100 voltage peak to peak, but requires a suitable attenuators for large signals. Oscilloscopes are fitted with a good cameras for recording purpose. Oscilloscope are fitted with a good camera for recording purpose. And Tektronix model 7094 is fitted with a lens of 1:1.2 Polaroid camera, which uses a 10,000 ASA film, which possesses a writing speed of 9 cm/ns. You can observe first is a plug-in amplifier, second is a Y amplifier, third is a internal delay line, and four is a trigger amplifier, five is a sweep generator, six is a X amplifier. This is the block diagram of such a test oscilloscope. With rapidly changing signals, it is necessary to initiate or start the oscilloscope time-based before the signal reach the oscilloscope deflecting plate. Otherwise, what happens? What they are saying? With a rapidly changing signals. For example, it may rise or it may decrease. Okay, rapidly changing, suddenly rise, suddenly decrease. Rapidly changing signals, it is necessary to initiate or start the oscilloscope time base before the signal reach the oscilloscope deflecting plate. Otherwise, a portion of the signal may be missed. Okay. Otherwise, what happens? A portion of the signal will be missed. Okay. Such measurements require an accurate initiation of the horizontal time base, and it is known as triggering. Okay. And it is known as triggering. Oscilloscopes are normally provided with both internal and external triggering facility. Oscilloscope, they have provided internal and also external triggering facility. Why we need triggering? Because to get the accurate initiation of the horizontal time base, okay, we require the accurate initiation of the horizontal time base. That's why we need an internal external triggering. When external triggering is used with the recording of impulses, the signal is directly fed to the actuate the time base and then apply to the vertical or Y deflecting plate through a delay line. The delay is usually 0.1 to 0.5 microseconds. The delay is obtained by a long interconnecting coaxial cable 20 to 50 in long. The required triggering is obtained from an antenna whose induced voltage is applied to the external trigger terminal. The measuring signal is transmitted to the CRO by a normal coaxial cable. The delay is obtained by an externally connected coaxial long cable to give the necessary delay. This arrangement is shown in the figure, that is 7.55. You can observe, okay. The impulse generator and the time base of the CRO are triggered from an electronic tripping device. A first pulse from the device starts the CRO time base, and after a predetermined time, a second pulse triggers the impulse generator. First pulse from the device starts the CRO time base, and after a predetermined time, a second pulse triggers the impulse generator. Okay, in next class, I will explain about the impulse measurements using multiple shield enclosures and signal cable.